Greetings, friends, and welcome to another tutorial in my series of building scenery for MSFS 2020 through SDK. A viewer asked for this video. The viewer requests that I do a video on replacing 2D boats that are present in the scenery from the aerial photography. This is not a big issue that I see that much in the United States. You can find boats in the imagery, but it doesn't seem to be as pronounced in the USA as other parts of the world. I assume that the aerial images in the USA are cleaned up more than in other parts of the world, but that is total speculation on my part. I have made several videos on scenery folder building and package building, so I will not go as deep into the basics as I normally go. If this is your first time at building scenery, I recommend that you learn how to build a scenery folder first, and then come back to this video. I will link some videos in the pinned comments that will walk you through the basics. I am presently at St. Martin Island. I have already worked on scenery here, and here at St. Martin, as best I recall, the scenery base maps are full of boats captured in the aerial imagery and have not been removed. So I will go through how I made changes to this area. The first step is to get out of normal mode and go into developer's mode. I can do that with a sim running, so I'll just hit escape. And then I'll go to General Options, Developers, Own, Apply and Save. And then I can hit Escape again and resume. I'm still at St. Martin. If you look up here at the top, you'll see my developer menu is here. I will go into the developer camera, from Camera, Developer Camera. So now let's take a look out in the bay. As you can see, there are many boats out in the bay that are 2D images taken when the aerial photography was taken. I have a package that I worked on here, so I'm going to open up that package and see exactly what I did to improve this area. It's been several months since I worked on this area, so I do not recall if I replaced every boat out in the bay or just some of the boats, but I do know I replaced boats, so let's take a look. So I'm going up to my developer's menu, tools, and I'm going to open the project editor. From the project editor, I'm going to go in and locate my scenery folder that I built several months ago by going to project, open project, and then I want to navigate to the folder in which I keep my scenery folder. Now that I'm in that folder, I'm looking for this here, NEP Studios St. Martin Lights. So I'm going to open this folder, drop down to the bottom XML, highlight the bottom XML, and open. It is now open, so I'm going back to my project editor. I'm going to tick on my project. I'm going to my scene. And I'm going to load in the editor. And now we will wait for the scenery to load in. With a scenery file I created several months ago, loaded into my objects, I can zoom down and take a look at what I placed over the 2D boats to kind of hide them. Obviously, I didn't take care of every boat, I can see that right now, but I did take care of several. Here's a boat here that I placed, so I'm going to tick on this boat. And if you look at the scenery editor, this is just listed as boat 01. I'll see if I can find some other boats I placed. It appears that I primarily use boat 01 and copied the image several times. I do notice that some of them I made a little larger. This is a little larger than this boat over here. And I did that by scaling the boat up. But it does not appear that I added a lot of choices here. I could have replaced every boat out here with some model if I wanted to, but I didn't. Since I'm here, I'm going to add a few more boats to my package, and that will give you an idea of how I built this package to begin with. I use boat 01 a lot, so I'm going to change and go with another style of boat just to make it interesting. So if you go up to your objects menu and you simply type in boat, that's when all the different boat models will populate over here and you can pick one. So I'm going to pick boat 02. As far as I can tell, I have not used boat 02 in this scenery. So by clicking on it, I'm just going to hit add. And now I'll go to the boat and scale it and try to cover up this 2D model. The first thing I want to do is make sure that the gizmo is up. If your gizmo is not up, go down to your scenery editor, view, and tick on gizmo, because I'm going to need the gizmo to reorientate and resize the boats. So with boat 02 placed over this aerial image, by having transmute ticked on the gizmo, it allows me to move the boat wherever I want. I'll go back to the gizmo and select rotate and move this boat into a better orientation. With rotate selected, I just spin the boat around. Now the boat appears to be a little small, so I'll go back to the gizmo, and you can click on scale and manually increase the size of the boat like this, or you can simply use the gizmo and type in a number and make the boat larger. So that looks pretty good. So I'm going to reuse this boat. So back to my gizmo and transmute. And down on my scenery editor, I'm going to select duplicate. I'm going to add a few of these boats in the area. I'll continue to duplicate and move boats in areas. You can do this as long as you want to and cover up as many boats as you want to. Or you can go in and find a different kind of boat. So I hit duplicate again, and it gives me a boat to put over there. That is a boat 01. I might as well copy that and bring this over too. Now I'm going to orientate through the gizmo. And I'm going to increase the scale. Boat seems to be large enough now to cover up the boat under it. And now I'm going to this boat 01 here, and I'm going to orientate it and place it beside the boat 02. Okay, that makes that look a little better. That is a fishing boat red. This is called a wash boat. Now, it's not a perfect match to a barge. This appears what I would call a barge. And I don't think I see any barges in my scenery. So I will just go ahead and see if I can scale this and hide this image. It's not a perfect match, but it does look better than what was here. I'm going to use this boat and just place it in a location to add some more boats to the area. So just by adding boats that are available to me in a Sobo scenery, I have improved the looks of the bay and covered up some, not all, but some of the boats in the bay. There is another option. If you go to the marketplace I typed in seafront and it brings up all the options in the marketplace. As you can see, I own three, and the assets from all three of these is located in my scenery every time that I load the sim up. And they're reusable. I have Vessels Enhanced AI installed, I have Global Shipping installed, and I have Vessels Core Library installed. And some of these I used in what you just saw. This is a way you can get additional boat models into your scenery library. The seafront boats are animated, so I'm going to add a few of the seafront boats, and these will be animated and they will move on the screen. To do that, I'm going to my objects menu. I'm going to move down and find seafront. All right, here is seafront. I'm going to tick on seafront so I only see seafront boats. I'm going to add a few yachts, and when I type in YAC in the objects menu, you will notice some of the seafront yachts pop up. So I'll just grab one, see what it looks like, and kind of experiment around. It's a good looking boat. So let's place it here. Here's a different seafront yacht. Going to orientate in size. This is a Super Yacht 01 from Seafront, and I know a perfect location for this. Going to rotate and scale. Now, that covers that boat up. Maybe move it a little bit. A little bit larger. Okay, that seems to work. I found another yacht I can move. So again, it's up to you to get as detailed as you want. But this is a simple tutorial on how you can cover up 2D boats that are in your scenery mesh. Now, I did make changes to my package, so I want to keep those changes. To do so, I'm going to my scenery editor. I'm going down and I'm going to tick save. The images are now saved. Now I'm going back to my project editor. Make sure I'm not on my scene or my model lib. Make sure that I'm on the project. Now that I'm ticked on the project, the inspector lights up and I can build the package again. Once a package is built, I can go up to my developer's menu. I can go to window and tick off the console. I can remove my tools now. So the changes I made to my scenery package are saved and they are in my folder. I will pull up my working scenery folder because this is the location of the package St. Martin Lights that I was working on. And I'm going to pull up my community folder. And I'm going to open St. Martin Lights. I'm going to look for packages. And here is my package. I'm going to copy and paste in my community folder. And now I have the changes that I made to the scenery in my package, in my community folder, and when I reload, I should see the boats as I place them. And now with my St. Martin scenery folder edited with additional boats I added to the scenery package, I've restarted the sim, and now I'm going to take a look at the work. And here you can see the boats that I placed over the 2D images. It's not perfect, but it's good enough for a flight sim. And it will give you 3D objects as opposed to the 2D images captured in the scenery mesh. It's that simple to cover up two-dimensional boats in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 through SDK. I could have began with a fresh package and walked you through that, but it's the same process I've used countless times in my videos to add scenery. It's up to you, it's up to your imagination, it's up to you the amount of time you want to spend and the amount of boats you want to replace. You can spend as much time as you like, and if I wanted to, I could have covered every boat out here in this harbor with a 3D model. However, having the majority of the boats covered with 3D models is good enough for me. But it's up to you, and you can add whatever you want. And thanks for watching. I do hope you got something useful out of this, and I particularly hope this helped my viewer that asked for this. And this is Patriot 6 signing off, and I hope to see you soon with more tutorials.